What's up, everyone? It's day 16 of phase 2 of the Live Hard program. I just finished my second workout of the day. It's currently 4:07 a.m. I did like I have been the last few nights or mornings. I woke up at about 12:15 midnight and did my first 45-minute workout. I did 45 minutes on the stair stepper, and then I did a little superset with of 10 sets total. I did pull-ups, push-ups, tricep extensions, and like hammer curls. I just rotated between those four things for 10 sets. It took about 15 or 20 minutes. After that, I drank a protein shake, Formula One Root Beer Float. That's my favorite right now. If you haven't tried it, it actually tastes like a root beer float, which is weird for a protein shake. And I didn't believe it at first until I tried it, but it's similar. And I like root beer, so it's probably one of my favorite sodas. But after that, I kind of just laid down, basically tried to take a nap. I don't think I actually fell asleep, but I was laying there. Then my alarm went off to go out and do my workout. I started hitting my ruck. I went 2.2 miles or so. It's only like 70 degrees right now. Nice cool breeze. There's less people here because it's Saturday morning. I'm at this man camp where I'm working at in West Texas. It's a little town called Orla. If you look it up, it's between Pecos, Texas, and Carlsbad, New Mexico. New Mexico border is like, I don't know, 5 miles away from me or 10 miles away. So it's pretty close, like right on the edge of a time difference. It's mountain time over there, and it's sometimes I have to worry about my phone switching and me not paying attention. But I got that done. Nice breeze, like I said. Right now I got some creatine, which everybody should take. I got first one, of course, with some L-carnitine. L-carnitine helps you use your fat as energy, and so you burn fat like that. It's pretty good though. It's pineapple coconut. I usually mix it with my aminos, but I didn't have it. My aminos were in my truck this morning and this was in here. And so I only had the aminos. So the aminos are pineapple, orange, banana. So that with pineapple coconut, it's very good. The creatine's unflavored though. It's pretty cheap though for everybody to be needing to take this. For 50 servings, it's like 25 bucks and it's legit. Anything you get from First Form is quality. It's not the stuff that you get at Walmart. So that was one of the things I used to always look at whenever I was buying supplements, because I've been taking supplements for probably 23 years. And I would always get like whatever was cheapest, and that was including like Walmart protein, that Body Fortress brand. It was like 15 bucks for a 2 pound thing. I was going through so many of those. And then later turned out they were full of garbage, fillers, just stuff that basically make the profile of the protein count higher with like taurine and different amino acids than actually getting a protein. And so it was basically fake. And the difference in the way that I felt and the way I looked is completely different than with First Form products or even any of them. Because I used to use Accent Sledge is what I was affiliated with before this. I still like to wear all the All-American Roughneck clothes because that's what I do. And that's just a clothing brand. But yeah, the Accent Sledge was good products, but it doesn't even come close to what First Form uses. Whatever they use for their ingredients and their testing, and as far as quality testing and flavor testing, they go harder than everybody. They're going to be one of the iconic companies that are always remembered, like Nike. And I believe they're branching out to start creating more apparel as well, kind of like a Under Armour when they took over back, I don't know how long that was, like 15 years ago. It's going to be 1P. But today, whenever I woke up, I did not want to get up. Today was the first day that I've switched to this little schedule that I'm on, going to sleep around 7:30 or 8 p.m. and getting up at midnight. Last night, I think it was probably closer to 8:30 when I actually fell asleep. So I think that's why I was more tired when I woke up today. But even after that, I was tired whenever it came time to do my outdoor workout. I had to make myself get up. And that goes along with all the other days where you're going to be going through this. If you're doing these phases or 75 hard, there's going to be a lot of days, 90% of the days, you're going to be not wanting to go do it. You're going to be tired. It's gonna set in that you're sore, and then it'll kind of just subside a little bit. And it helps whenever you take your aminos and your protein and your different supplements to help with repairing your muscles as you break them down. But when your feet hurt from walking, you can't really avoid that. So you just kind of get used to it. You'll get blisters on your feet. You'll probably wear out a pair of shoes if you're doing the 75 and then the phase one together, probably, because that's 105 days in a row. If you're doing the same, you don't always have to go outside and rug. That's just something that I do because, I don't know, Andy does it, I guess. But you can go out and do anything. Sometimes whenever I'm at home, I'll use my speed bag and like do burpees in my driveway. I've done that a lot. But the point is, you're not always going to be motivated. And a lot of the time, you're going to have to just dig deep and get yourself up to go do it. I got myself up to go do it. I don't necessarily feel like I have overcame the tiredness, but I feel good because I went and did it. And I know that I'm going to have no issues completing the rest of my tasks for today because I already set myself up with both my workouts done. I have drinks, 5 bottles of water because I'm not counting this one. So it would have been 6. You're supposed to just drink water in a gallon, or a gallon's worth of water, specifically just water, like not mixed with aminos, not mixed in your protein shake, not tea, not coffee, just straight water. You can add those other things on top of it, but you're not supposed to count it. So I'm on 5 because I wake up, I chug one, I take 3 with me to the workout, and I drink 2 after, this is 2, but after this, between my workout and my second workout. But yeah, that's the main thing I was going to talk about today, was you just have to understand that if you're going to be doing this, it's going to suck, it's going to be hard, it's going to be annoying. It's called 75 hard and live hard for a reason. It's not live easy. It's not 75 easy. It's not do as you, it doesn't, it's not change the tasks to fit your schedule. You change your schedule to fit the tasks. Like you can see, I'm getting up at midnight. I don't want to get up at midnight, but I also don't want to be doing my ruck at 7 p.m. or 6 p.m. So a lot of times out here in West Texas, it's really windy during the day and not so much during the night. It kind of calms. So that's another reason I don't want to be walking into a dust storm. If you saw some of my videos, maybe at the beginning of this phase, I was walking through this area. Dust tornadoes are always popping up. So I'd just be walking and all of a sudden one would just sneak up and just be throwing dust on me. So I'm trying to avoid that, as well as the 100 degree temperatures. Like today, it's supposed to be 95, so not as hot, but still, it's humid out here. You would think it would be kind of dry, but it's not. It's humid, and it's just, you know, you got to set yourself up to be able to get the tests done in the way that you're going to be able to accomplish them. So for me, this schedule works right now. I'm only going to be able to do this till, like, Tuesday morning. I'll have to wake up at like 3:30, get my first workout in, and probably do my outside workout during my work shift, because I'll have to get off work at 6 p.m. and drive home 7 hours. So it's just a matter of planning your day around the tasks. If you're doing the phases, or if you're doing the 75 hard, or even if you're in between and you're just living your life, you have to understand that you're taking the discipline from the phase. The Live Hard program is not going to just make you successful or winning or completely better. You have to take what you learn and the discipline that you learn and acquire over the time during the phases in the 75 Hard program, and you have to pivot and use it in your regular life. So you have to change the tasks. You don't necessarily have to go and take a picture, or you should probably read, but. And you don't have to do 2 workouts. It's not necessarily something you have to keep doing. Whenever you're in the shape that you want to be in, you can kind of cut back on the workouts to do 1, and then maybe add a task of something that you want to get better at or something you want to learn. And that needs to be your focus, because otherwise you're just going to be correcting yourself with these phases and these tasks that aren't necessarily pushing you to do what you should be doing to become successful in the way that you want to be successful, whatever that entails. It could be anything. You can just fill in the blank. But for me, one of the things that I was trying to get better at, which I didn't even put any effort into still, was learning to edit videos and move up basically through the Legionnaire program with First Form. It's the affiliate program. They have all kinds of content they put out daily in an app that I'm part of, obviously, if I'm part of it. But yeah, just slacking. And right now I'm kind of just slacking because I'm doing these other things for the phase. So it's just a matter of buckling down and doing the things that you got to get started. That's the main thing. You have to get started. Once you get started, you always hear people say, oh, why didn't I start sooner after they get the results they wanted? Well, I'm in that part where I don't necessarily need results with my body. I'm trying to get results with money, basically, or becoming more beneficial to people watching this and getting better at making better content. Because the point of this channel was, whenever I started it, to do things with my daughter, which started out as doing cookie reviews. And then part of that, of setting an example, is setting an example. And you have, for me as a father, I'm going to set the example for other people to see that, yeah, you can do the things that are fun with your kids and do all this stuff, but you have to make sure that you're good too. And whether you're mom or dad, it doesn't matter. You have to correct yourself, because you got to heal yourself. I mean, that's just the way it is. You can't pass your traumas down to your kids. So the best way to correct that is listen to episode 208 on the Real AF feed with Andy Frisella and learn all about the 75 Hard and Live Hard program. And if you're interested, you can go to episode 665. That's episode 75 Hard versus me, Chris Hibbs, and Carly Thackeray. We won the contest last year. We got to go on the podcast this year. And check it out. See what we talk about. I know a lot of you probably have. I appreciate all the support that I get. Actually, I haven't really had any negative comments on any of my videos, and I have like 150 videos up now. So I know it's because, one, that people that are watching it want to see it, and it's not like just, you know, viral or whatever. I'm not having hundreds of thousands of, or even thousands of people watch it. So I'm sure the comments would change when people that were haters were watching it or whatever, but I don't really have that right now. So I appreciate all the support, because it gets me to understand that I'm actually doing something that's helping people along their journey. So just keep going. Like I said, the main thing I was going to talk about today was just reiterating that you are not always going to be motivated. You're going to have to just force yourself to do the things, whatever it is, whatever the thing is, you're going to have to force yourself to do it. And yet ultimately you feel better after you do it. You may not feel energized. You may not feel like that much different at the time, but you have to just know that you're stacking these wins up to, you know, get you to a certain other level. And along the way, it's going to be hard. It's going to be tiring. It's going to be suck. You're going to be sore, but it's always going to be worth it. And the main thing is to just not quit. So that's all I got for today. It's 4:20. I got to take a shower and get ready for work. I'll be back tomorrow for day 17. Peace.